Greetings, sir and sirettes, and welcome back to From the Depths with me, Lathrix, and welcome to a bit of an odd theory slash building slash just messing around video. Today we're going to be playing around with different types of cannon and deciding which will eventually grace our ships, because a big ship rehaul is overdue in the Lathrixian fleet. The main cause of this is block count. When I first started building ships, the block count maximum in a battle was over 100,000, meaning that you could have several ships which were quite large in a battle very easily. These days, the default settings without messing with a lot of very sketchy things is 50,000 in a battle, meaning that the hull can only be brought on its own because it is 20-something thousand, meaning we are going to need to remake our ships, and as a result, we need to mess around with new weapons. So, you see in front of you a 9-cannon, a 9-cannon turret, which I've been messing around with. I actually just posted a miniature From the Depths video, which I may be taking down when I publish this video, so you may not be able to see it. Oh well. And it was just the first ever test firing. And honestly speaking, it did okay. So let's quickly spawn in a... Where are you? I've been testing them against the Thunderbirds, because this is not meant to be an anti-air weapon, but it's a good test because the Thunderbird goes about 60-70 meters per second. It's quite quick, but also quite large, so it mimics the fastest kind of ships we will be targeting. Plus, it's in the air, so when it explodes, it's rather cool. Well, that just caused my game to crash, so here's a second spawn in, this time a more manual spawn, just to make sure everything's going okay. Probably shouldn't have spawned it in front of us, considering that did mean that the lasers instantly hit us, but still, at least it gave the cannon a good chance to actually get a good lock on. There we are, a couple of seconds of the cannon, and a huge chunk of the plane has been rendered, well, destroyed. Okay, also please bear in mind that the cannon currently has no armor, and its AI is as basic as it comes. It's literally fire at center of mass, keep firing until enemy is dead. Which should be quite soon. Also, every one of the turrets does have a different setup to every other one. This is why the shots are a little bit more of a spray rather than in volleys. It also does mean that some have higher armor piercing than others, some have more explosive damage. You get the gist. The whole point of it is to do a range of damages. Okay, well that went exceedingly well for a damage test. So what else could we test against then? How about the Onyx Watch, who've been recently killing us a lot, and let's spawn in one of these lovely fellows. Well, before we start fighting a live ship, I've just spawned in one above the hull, just to have a look at it, and I've made some changes to the prefab. It now uses some recoil-suppressing barrels, and I've increased the accuracy by a tiny little bit. I don't want it to be too accurate, considering it's kind of a spray-and-pray kind of cannon. However, I found it was a little bit too wide-aiming for even that. So hopefully this will do better. This one over here isn't hooked up to any AI whatsoever. It's simply been spawned on the deck. Okay, so let's see how this does versus something that will actually try to kill us. The Alcazar, for instance. Okay, firing a little bit early there. One of the cannons, two of the cannons, since it is mirrored, definitely don't have enough explosive barrels or armor piercing, which kind of sucks, but, well, that... Yeah, that was an Alcazar. It's like it's been dissected. Okay, I think we can happily assume this turret does a lot of damage. And yeah, the increased accuracy has definitely helped. By a long shot, actually. That'll make fighting the more ocean-bound enemies. Even perhaps some submarines, which don't go too deep, quite well. Okay, then. Let's see if we can put this cannon on something more permanently. Okay, also, again, the AI hasn't been set up, so it's been eating its own ship, of course. How about on the Alcazar itself? I mean, I was saying I may improve that, or the... What's it called? The Bulwark. Let's have a quick look at that. So, let's spawn in an Alcazar. Now, a quick look-see. Where would I actually put the cannon, since we do have a stolen one still currently in the actual campaign? So we could do this live after I've built... Did I just spawn that? Deepwater guard. Whoops, there's. Okay, destroy all enemy vehicles. We don't want to keep fighting. You just repair, you weird version of the Lathrixian Pride. Okay, so. Alcazar, our team. So, like I was going to say, the top section there seems quite, well, probably big enough, honestly. And I know for a fact that the innards here are actually hollow. Other than the turret itself, which we aren't going to be using. Perhaps we could force its way there. Let's see how much space this actually takes up. Yep, that is far too big. Wow! Okay, that really shows how big the Lathraxian Pride is in comparison to most other ships. So if I were to use this cannon on the Alcazar, we would have to do some serious size management. So yeah, that's the widest section there is. We'd have to essentially cut off the top section here completely and go down to the next level, which is certainly a doable feat. It's not too much effort and would also lower the block count of the Alcazar, allowing at minimum two of them in battle at any given time, even with the addition of shields and such, which I'm going to add in the future. And because this is sandbox mode, nothing here is permanent, so let's give it a go. Okay, so there is a plan B and a plan C. So plan B is to simply convert the Lathraxian Pride into a permanent housing for this turret. Plan C is to try and streamline the turret so it is either less wide but simply goes down further into the ship, or we weaken it a little bit and make it more compact, as despite the fact it's all very splayed out like this, this is actually rather compact, other than these two segments here and here, which actually wouldn't make too much of a difference if I did compact them in any further. So I'm not sure which one I'm going to go with. I am leaning towards simply making a version of the Lathraxian Pride, perhaps the Lathraxian Spite or Envy or Redemption or something rather silly like that. And I think that is what I'm going to do. So I'm going to spawn in one of the original Lathraxian Prides. I'm going to, once again, cut out its insides, although I have already did that for the Lathraxian Spite prototype. I didn't do it very well, I simply did it as a testing for the turret itself. I really want this turret to go on one of our ships, that's the thing. I was messing around with this earlier, and that's kind of where everything's revolving around. This turret will be a thing. And then probably more turrets if we're going to keep the Lathraxian Spite as a permanent battling ship rather than its hangar variant, which of course will be the Pride. Failsafe has been added. Some very basic aim restrictions are going to be added later. That means it won't be able to fire very far down. That will encourage it to, well, not be able to shoot the own ship. And I think it will be pretty much safe to keep where it is. I was going to raise it a little, but then it dawned on me that the amount of metal we would need to raise all the armor with it would be rather atrocious. And yes, currently this thing is all open-ended because I've been messing around with the inside and the turret. So let's see here then. I'm also going to replace the glass. As much as I do love this being here, considering now this segment's going to be of a lot more importance than with the Pride, as well, before they only housed some basic broadside cannons. Do I want to make some broadside? We could very easily add some of the Onyx Watch broadside cannons in here. Just need to break out this section a little bit. I think I'll do that. Okay, but for now, let's start work on the actual turret piece itself and actually armoring this thing up. So, we really shouldn't spare any expense when it comes to armoring this thing because, well, it's going to be the main weapon by quite a long shot and we don't want it to be knocked out early game. If this thing gets knocked out, the whatever I'll end up calling this ship will be essentially neutered. It's going to be absolutely dreadful. So, let's go ahead. How far do I want it? I want it so when it's not fighting, it doesn't really go over here, if by much at least. I mean, that would be okay. That would be okay. And now I'm thinking I should redo it in a different colour, however. I thought that the section up here was the default metal, but apparently it's already the darker metal. Okay, let's change that around. We can also lose some of the inside of the ship in this section here because we probably won't be spawning planes with this thing on the back because we'll just end up destroying every plane we create. So let's not do that and let's continue with our previous plan. Let's put down as a basic foundation. So, how... a little bit bigger perhaps, I think. Yeah, let's a little bit bigger. Let's make it so... in fact, I know what we should do. We should have this on the inverted. There we are. Have that go there, then we add the, where are you, corner segment. What I'll do in a second is I'll put these on the hotbar so I can actually just change from one to the other. That's probably the best idea. There we go. Yeah, something like that. Then that way it can kind of rise up with the turret and slowly enclose most of the barrels. Of course, we'll also be adding heavy, heavy shielding onto this thing to prevent cannons from simply devouring its soul. Because that's what cannons actually do. It's a little known fact. Sorry about that, but I want to put that there. Okay, so I'll just carry on up like that and see how that looks. Well, after rising it up several levels, I've decided it really isn't going to look very good, purely because of the sheer size of the thing. So instead, we're going to go with more of a traditional looking turret, probably more of a blocky kind of circle, similar to the Onyx Watch, but with more support struts and stuff. So we're going to go with a very industrial looking section, but I will endeavour to make it look as good as my abilities will allow, which of course isn't too good, but let's see how it ends up. Not quite finished yet, but let's give it a quick test fire just to ensure that the metal isn't in the way of the turrets. Now, the one big problem is, because of how staggered these turrets are, they are liable to get damaged and then actually damage the turret casing itself. So I'm a little bit nervous about the barrels in the future, but I quite like the look of this. Again, I'm going for industrial, kind of simplistic, which I do love the look of, and I'm slowly getting better. Not the best looking thing in the world, but I do like it. So I'm thinking about adding some blue and green to it, making it look a bit more sci-fi. Doesn't really matter what we summon in. Summon in the water buffalo. Apparently this thing is built to take damage for the deep water guard. It's doing just that in a little bit of testing. Well, that seemed rather reasonable to me. We still have to change some of the turret segments so that all of them are firing the both explosive and armor-piercing rounds. I think I've narrowed it down to which barrels it is now anyway, so it shouldn't be too much of an issue. So let's carry on with this. I'm not quite sure what to do with the back section. I'm thinking of just keeping it as we've been doing the front here, with these kind of spidery legs and kind of hollowed out sections, and have it trying to look a bit like pipes on the back. Perhaps that's where we'll add the colour. Oh yeah, that's where we'll add the colour, and then we can keep the top here green. I was kind of fighting myself. Do I want to have a poster on the top? Actually, do posters even work on turrets? That's a good question. I actually have no idea whatsoever. There we are, post holder. Yep, they work. Excellent. So we could have a poster on here still, which would be kind of nice. We could perhaps have a symbol of corn as we're going down the route of quite, well, chaotic mayhem, bloodletting, evil, just outright damage rather than the Nurglean side of things. Or we could have a symbol of Nurgle, or we could perhaps even have a symbol of Lathrix, have one of my older avatars. I don't really know. So many choices. That's quite a nice effect. Okay, so with the little window ridges, if we simply add some metal, some green metal behind it, it does kind of look almost as if it's a curtain or something, so that's rather glorious. Okay, there we are. I'm not entirely happy with the front of this thing, but I am very happy with the sides and the back. The front looks a little bit too stunted, although it does look as if we could maybe open up this segment here to allow it to look as if the turret can actually move freely, even if that does make it infinitely more vulnerable. So we could do that in the future, rather. In the past we could do it, wow. But for now, I think we'll just leave this as it is. I think it's a good base turret. It's a good thing to work on later. But right now, I really don't have infinite time. Once again, I've ended up recording in a non-recording slot. So for those who don't know, I mean, a lot of YouTubers do this, and I'm just speaking for myself here, though. People tend to record in, let's see, once they make it their job, they tend to record in slots so that they don't spend too much time recording and burn themselves out. I know that I'm particularly vulnerable to this. If I play a game too much when recording, I can very easily grow bored of the entire game, which I don't really want to do, so I try to limit myself. But I always find that From the Depths is a game that randomly makes me really want to play it when I'm not meant to be recording, so I end up being guilty of just turning on the game, and that's a two long, not a one long, which means we should have this. Yes. Do I actually want that there? That's the question. Does that even look decent? I can dig that. Okay, I'm okay with that. Add slope section. No, the 2 meter rather. There we are. And then we do the same underneath. and that will provide some armour from being shot from the front, as well as looking quite okay, in my opinion. And this is actually a one wide, isn't it? Ugh. I always find it so difficult to find things here. Maybe it's just because I'm dyslexic. I do find all the words kind of jumbled together really badly there. Maybe it's just the style of how it's been presented. I'm okay with that. Okay, so that's the main turret there. Actually, no, the main turret technically is this one. The main cannon piece. This is what the turret uses to actually aim. The rest are just fired around there. So when it's firing, this is aiming directly at the enemy, then all of these are firing around it in that pattern. Which does lead to some pretty interesting shots. Okay, well, I'm pretty happy with that once again. Let's give it another test. This time versus a paddle gun. Will it fire before it gets killed? Oh, it's not facing the right way. Yeah, I'm okay with that. Oh, it did start to fire! No, just as it fell, it started firing a couple of shells. Oh, you poor thing. Okay, so the turret's done then. Let's just stop that. Stop. My eardrums need to rest. So now we have to consider how we're going to do the rest. We're currently at 13,000 blocks, still a full 10,000 less than the Hold missile, but still 15,000 is kind of where I want to end up. So obviously this has to be filled in, that's just a necessity, but the question is, what do we do here? Let's see how big some of the missiles are. Let's go, some of the missiles, some of the turrets from the Onyx Watch are. I've got missiles on my mind. I'm considering where I'm going to put them. Don't want the turtle, eh? Where are you? There's the Bulbul and the Sidebul. Now, the Bulbul, it's from the Bulwark. The Bulbul is the, I believe, the two-turreted one that you find directly forward. Well, that's frozen in time. Interesting. How big is this? That's not actually too big. That could probably be used in the side quite easily without me having to make a brand new turret. The good thing with these is that they are completely self-contained. They're not an in-hull turret. The problem is with them, they're not actually that good on their own. The reason why the Bulwark and the Alcazar do so well is because of the sheer number of them. Then there's the larger variation, which obviously can't possibly go in the side. I mean, we could put it in the side if we were to knock the walls in between the two little segments here away and then have this somewhere in the middle facing outwards like that. No, it's still too tall. It's still definitely too tall. So how tall is the other one? Are we going to have to make... Yeah, okay, so we're going to have to make our own turret. That's fine. Or simply use the... Is it the whole side? Nope. So many different turrets. One of these is the one I'm thinking of. There it is. That's one of the smaller in-hull turrets I have. So we could use that. And that wouldn't be a terrible idea. That way we have some broadside action there. Or we could put them here instead. Now, I don't want them here and here, where the last turret was, as there was a very small turret which we put just one lower than that, even if it does go there quite well. Purely because that kind of limits the amount of firing arc that the main turret has, and the main turret is going to be pretty much everything we want in this, so it's going to be all the offensive capabilities. I also now think that these hangars here will probably be used for missiles, so we could do is put these a little bit further down, have them planted here somewhere. If we were to flatten out this section a little bit, merge this here and this here, then provide a little space for them to rest and perhaps aim outwards. There we are. We have now got the original area there nice and blocked off. Also, it turns out there was over 500 blocks of glass, so that did free up 500 blocks. Well, we did then have to replace them with armoured beams, but that's only a third of the size, so we did save a lot of blocks there, which of course is still our big concern. Now, as for the turrets and the missile system has already been sneakily added here, and it goes in and under the armour segment, so it's actually quite well protected. They will most likely be just regular missiles, and we'll be using ejectors to make sure they get away from the turret as fast as possible so that they don't detonate by accident, and they'll probably just be one turn fragmentation warheads, absolutely nothing out of the ordinary. Did it a million times, and I'll do it a million times more, and that will be the main backup weaponry all in that area. It also means I have an excuse to armor that area up more, meaning that the turret is even more secure, and it's pretty secure as it is. Now, these two spikes I'm probably going to change along with the ramp, because obviously we're not using this as an aircraft carrier anymore, at least this variation of the Lathraxian Pride, so there's no point for a runway. So this is going to be flattened, probably around about here, and brought out, and this is where the secondary turret will go. Now, the secondary turret will probably be a variation of the ones I've already shown, but more likely it'll be similar to this turret, which was the large turret on the original hull. Ta-da! But with a much larger actual turret segment for armor, and probably multiple barrels attached to it. So imagine two or three of those attached to each other. That will be somewhere here, probably about this high, maybe a little bit lower. And remember, this turret won't be able to shoot down at all, so it won't be able to fire any lower than this, so the chance of them... Well, that and the failsafe, the chance of it hitting its own turret in front of it will be basically zero. So that's fantastic. As for the rest of the ship, honestly, I'm very tempted to eradicate the front section from here and simply pull it back so it's a much smaller ship. That will save us a lot of blocks and a lot of resources, and will make this ship a lot more usable as a standard ship in our forces. So that's the plan so far. I'm not sure how much of that's definitely going to happen, particularly with the flattening of this area, because I just kind of like this ramp. But I'm afraid, though, I am all out of time. That's what happens when you record in a non-recording session. Thank you so much for watching. If you have enjoyed this episode, then of course likes, favorite, shares, comments, all that good stuff helps out me, helps out the channel, and most importantly shows that From the Depths is a series you wish to see continued in the future. Next time we'll be attacking the Onyx Watch once more and showing them what a real cannon looks like. Thank you again, and goodbye.